insert statement will not include the primary key if you're using an auto number table. So in this case, for faculty, FID is an auto number. I would not have to include FID in the list of columns. In fact, I don't think I could include FID because that's an auto number field. All right. So insert into table, column, values. Auto numbers, you don't have to put in that, all those automatically get generated. And that really makes your life easy, right, to a degree. That sort of simplifies things. I thought you were asking if there was an error in the SQL statement, would it use up that number? And I don't think it did, but I'm not really sure. I'm pretty sure it doesn't, but I guess I'm not 100% sure. Now, you might ask, why doesn't this look like the update statement? And my answer there is I have no idea. It doesn't. Whoever made it up not to look like the update statement. It would be easier if instead of update, the syntax for an insert would be about the same, but that's not the case, so you have to learn the syntax too. All right, so let's get into inserting into this table. And I'm going to use a details view to insert. Probably next time we'll talk about using a form that's not a grid view or a details view, but a form that I code myself to do an insert. But for this example, we'll use a details view. Do a couple things here. First of all, I'm going to make this such that I'm going to change this back to having a default mode of read-only. Because now I don't always want to edit. I want to sometimes insert. So I'm going to go in and change that to read-only as opposed to edit. All right, so I changed the default mode of that. Let's go into this data source, and let's go and add an insert, and let's go and add a delete so that we can do the full range of things on this guy. So I'll go into configure data source. I can put my delete in, which will simply be delete from faculty where FID equals ? Alright. And I can put my insert statement in, which I'll put it in Notepad. That's what my insert statement looks like. All right. Now, I can say on this grid view, I want to enable deleting and enable inserting. Okay? Now, let's go and play around with this a little bit and see what we get. All right, we go and run this. Let's make sure we did not break edit first. So we'll go and we'll view Blanchard, and we'll edit them, and we'll say Blanchard's actually Tony Blanchard. I click update, and okay, the update works. here and try to delete Tony, ooh, we get that ugly error. All right. How do we fix that? Same thing we did a minute ago with the update. So let's remember we're going to do that. All right, we're going to put in the item deleted event. We're going to put that. Now, watch how awkward it is to insert someone. Let's make sure it works, first of all. Then we'll talk about maybe alternatives on how to do this better. If I want to insert a new person, I click Blanchard. Then I click New. And then I get a blank page. And I can put in a new faculty person. And, oh, I didn't put drop-downs for those, so I have to code in the actual values. I then click Insert. I go back to Blanchard, and if I go back and refresh, there they are. Okay, that's sort of awkward, right? Because I have to click on someone to get into insert mode. I really don't want to do that. All right, I want to go right into insert mode if I want to insert someone. All right, so I'm going to make a couple of changes now. Let's talk about a couple of quick changes that we can make, but we'll handle sort of the biggest change of, gee, it's sort of awkward the way that the insert works. We'll handle that one next time. In addition, we'll write our own insert form. So let's go in here and, let's do this first. By the way, we have the same problem with the insert that we had with the delete, right? No validation. So let's go and address that by duplicating this code for the item inserted event and the item deleted event. Okay, so now we should be okay with that. So if we go and run this, we try to delete this guy and it tells us we have an error. And we could do a better job phrasing that error, but in the interest of time, we're okay. Or if I click new here and try to insert someone that doesn't exist, it indicates I have an error. Kind of awkwardly, but it does indicate that.
Why didn't it delete when you told it to delete?
Because there was an error. Because there's related rows to that person.
Oh.
All right. But if I successfully add someone here, and insert it, then it adds that person to the list. Okay? So, we have the full range of insert, update, and delete, but it's still pretty clunky. All right? What do we need to do? Well, we need, first of all, on the insert, we need to add drop-downs, right? So that they don't have to memorize the faculty ranks or they don't have to memorize the locations. We need to make sure both the insert and the update have drop-downs for it. We also need to make sure that that we get around the clunkiness of having to pull an existing person up when we want to go and insert a new person. All right, we should be able to jump right into insert mode, ideally from this page. So that's what we'll look at next time. So we've done the full range of inserts, updates, and deletes, but we can make them a lot cleaner. And cleaning it up will be our first job in next class. And then looking at a different way to do an insert will be the job after that. All right, so that'll probably take us through Thursday. I will post this example, and then I'll unlock lab first, and then I'll come back and do my thing with the videos and example, and then I'll be back.